Mohammad Sol. Sea el segundo.
Hello everybody. I hope you're doing well. This is Mohammad Sol, and my thesis is sobre Sol. It's a pleasure for me to be here among you and present my master thesis on 3 consecutive years of eclipse chasing. I'm an amateur astronomer and a photographer and tourism activist, and I found this subject very interesting for me. In the world of astronomy, a total solar eclipse is one of the most spectacular nature show. In the world of tourism, an astrotourism in a modern way is quite a new issue, since there are not so many researches on it in the world. And eclipse chasing is this thesis is a pioneering work, because this is the first thesis so far on eclipse chasing. This map shows the story in brief. In 2026, 2027, and 2028, the passage of totality and annularity of 3 solar eclipses will cross over Spain, and this is a great opportunity for Spain to host many people and eclipse observers to come to travel to Spain and get ready for a great show in the sky. The first total solar eclipses, 2026 and 2027, are total one. And the last one, which is 2028, is the annular one. So eclipse chasing is traveling to observe an eclipse, and eclipse chasers are people that travel to observe solar eclipses. Eclipse chasing has 2 parts. Eclipse refers to astronomy, and chasing refers to tourism. In the other word, eclipse chasing without tourism is impossible. An eclipse doesn't go to you. You have to go and travel, and this is the role of tourism in this project. So you see, total and annular solar eclipses from 2021 to 2020 to 2040. And there are people that travel long distances in order to be in the right place to observe solar eclipses. And you see what's happening in Spain. Blue ones are total ones, and red ones are annular ones. So, importance of the events. The first one, the eclipse of 2026. This is their path of totality. So this is the first total solar eclipse to occur over the Europe since 1999. It happens during the summer vacations, and the other one, Spain will be the focal point of eclipse gatherings in the whole world. And this is what is going to appear in the sky. It's not a painting. This is what is seen simple vista, by naked eyes. So, this is the second one, the eclipse of 2027 that crosses over the southern coast of Spain. And you see Gibraltar, Malaga, Tarifa, and some more places will be in the path of totality. This is the second longest totality in the 21st century. Great opportunity. And Spain would be the only European country to observe it. And once again, it happens during the summer vacations. We have the potential of vacations and tourism. And there won't be any further more totality in whole Europe till 2053. And the last one, which is the annular one, this is the longest annularity in the century, and the spectacular view of the sun above the horizon. That's what is seen just a few minutes before the sunset. So general objective of the project is providing a primary study and necessary information about the upcoming events, and trying to present it to the relevant entities to start an early planning. Early planning in order to prepare Spain for hosting one of the greatest solar eclipse events through history. So, I have conducted this project cooperating with many people, astronomy experts, NASA experts, and so many famous people, generous people that helped me throughout the project, such as Dr. Jay Pasekov, NASA astronomer, an expert eclipse chaser that has seen over 50 total solar eclipses in his life. He edited my questionnaire word by word. Generosity. Dr. Kate Russo, an eclipse chaser, an eclipse consultant. She is an Australian astronomer, an eclipse chaser. And lovely Dr. Jay Anderson, Canadian astronomer and eclipse meteorologist. He gave me some materials that they were necessary for the project. Weather cloud maps. So I have defined two type of public for my project, astronomers and unprofessional people, people interested. So I have designed two types of questionnaire for each type. And the result in brief, so they have mentioned that they need clear skies, good food, good company, ease of access, being far from the crowd during the eclipse time, nice landscapes, tourism infrastructures, and more. So I have featured some best locations for each eclipse. For example, for the first one, I have prepared this table, the best places in Spain. For example, we have Tarragona here. The eclipse starts at this time, ends at this time. The best time for observing the eclipse, duration of totality, and so on. This is, for example, for the first one. For the next one, and for the last one. So these are the cloud cover maps that Dr. Jay Anderson gave me. So it shows that the weather condition in Spain would be perfect. I mean, the blue area is clear skies. So this is perfect. This is a perfect news for us because we need clear skies and we already have it. This is, this map is a bit complicated to be provided. It takes a long time to provide these maps, and he did it just for me, just for this project. The second map, this is perfect in the southern coast. We have clear skies, and this is another good news. So, for many, many reasons, I suggest the potentials of biosphere reserves for eclipse observation for many, many reasons, so I do not have time to explain. But in this map, I have mentioned, you see, blue areas are biosphere reserves. And there are so many biosphere reserves within the path of totality and annularity. For example, in the first eclipse, we have only 23 biosphere reserves. This is a great potential. The second one and the last one. We have lots of biosphere reserves in the path of totality. So how to start early planning? So the fundamental action would be founding an eclipse task force. This eclipse task force may include a diverse range of stakeholders, such as representatives from MAP program, Hombre y Biosfera, in Castellano, Ministries of Energy, Tourism, autonomous communities, creative industries, International Astronomy Union, educational sector, European Space Agency, and so on. So I have presented a good number of activities for this eclipse. For example, take advantage of the potentials of the Caminos de Santiago. This is a great idea to link, to join activities, eclipse, and Caminos de Santiago. So I believe that the first eclipse can be known worldwide as the Spanish Great Eclipse and be promoted worldwide as the Great Spanish Eclipse. So finally, you see, I have shown the autonomous communities. You see, apart from Canary Islands, all comunidades autónomas, they are in within the path of totality and annularity. This is a great potential for us. Dear friends, I'm here not only to present my master thesis, I'm here to invite you for a greater cooperation. I believe that through an inter-university network, we can do a greater job. We can start early planning. The earlier we start early planning, the less opportunities we lose.
Okay.
So I believe that the benefits are not only financial benefits. We can have greater benefits in terms of education, astronomy, cultural benefits, and much more. So this is the last eclipse photo I took. It's just a couple of days before presenting my master. It's just in the north of Tenerife, Canary Islands. And so I have to thank many people throughout the project. Thank you so much, friends here, participants, people of university, people of Intur, and fortunately, I found amazing people on my way, such as my advisor. She's already here, Professor Silvia Grau. I owe her a very special thanks, the best company, and now we have decided to work together and just to do a greater job and to start early planning as earlier as possible. So thank you so much. Have a good day. Okay. And let's keep in touch.
So thank you very much for your presentation, and I would like to ask you, because I don't know if I understand quite well, how why did you link this to the biosphere reserve? Did you get it from your service?
So the question was why I linked the biosphere reserve to the eclipse, no?
Yeah.
Because of many reasons, it's complicated, I have already mentioned, but for example, according to the questionnaires, this was like a concerns of astronomers. They need landscapes. They need beautiful landscapes. And for example, the mission of biosphere reserves are like ecotourism, sustainable tourism, scientific way for tourism development. And this project provides. Moreover, many astronomers have mentioned that they want to be away from the crowd in the day of eclipse. So they should be away from the big cities. So this is biosphere reserve. This is a big response for our concerns.
Okay. Gracias. Muchas gracias, Muhammad.